bonjour mes amis. Comment ça va? I gotta tell you, Happy New Year, first of all. Today is January the 6th, 2022. I'm driving to work. And, of course, listening to the news, if you can call it news. And just thought I should let off a little steam because the pressure in me builds up a little bit hearing all these people talking about what happened last year on January the 6th. And these people, I want to remind you about some other things these same people have been talking about over the last few years. Let's just take, for example, something that's on everybody's mind. COVID. First-hand information. I'm going to tell you some first-hand information. Not statistics from any newspaper or any television program or any network. No, just personal statistics. And I want you to think about your own personal first-hand knowledge and statistics. Everybody I know that is suffering or has suffered from the new variant, the current variant. Variants are kind of like latest fashions. The new variant of COVID, everybody I know personally that is suffering from that has had full vaccination, and most of them have had the booster as well. Every one of them. And I'm not talking about just one or two. I know a lot of folks, and every one of them that is suffering from the latest version, the latest fashion of COVID, has been vaccinated. Now, the president and his team have been telling us over and over and over again that this is a pandemic of the unvaccinated. Well, we know that's bull. Bull, you know what? You know that's BS. We know that. And to tell you the truth, you know, I'm not that upset about what these people say to us anymore. They lie constantly. I'm not surprised by that at all. What I am having a hard time with is the incredibly ignorant masses of people that continue to genuflect at the altar of Lemonade and Biden's declarations. I mean, yesterday he said, this is a pandemic of the unvaccinated. No, sir, Mr. President, the vaccinated are getting sick. Now, I'm not a scientist. Maybe it is true that people are not getting as sick if they had the vaccine. Let's face it. The vaccines were created by people that really love their job and wanted to do the right thing. And since we had an administration that kicked things into high gear, warp speed, the real scientists were allowed to work on a vaccine that they thought would help stop this dreaded disease that we are still not really pursuing the truth about its origins. Why are we not going after that? Why is that being ignored? The Chinese Communist Party still gets a free pass on that. But I digress. Today being January the 6th, we are hearing all this gobbledygook about what happened last year. And I brought up the vaccines and COVID because how much BS we've been issued on that subject. Let me back up a little bit before that. Remember Russia, Russia, Russia? These are the same people getting up and talking about January 6th and giving us their version of facts. These are the same people that Russia, Russia, Russia was coming out of their mouths constantly. You know, Pelosi, Schiff, all that bunch. And guess what? The top prosecutors, some of the best in the business, found out all of that was not true. Not true at all. They've been telling a story along with Limon that was completely false. So, I could go further back. We could go back to the same people that didn't tell us the truth about Benghazi or IRS targeting or gun running on the border. Remember? Fast and Furious. Clinton cash. The uranium sales. What about Hillary Clinton's emails? You know, we still... Why is there no committee looking into that? You know, there's a duplicity, a double standard, a hypocrisy that we've been watching now for years. So again, we're not surprised by the lies that these people tell over and over and over. We know it's their way. It's who they are. These are the same people that want to lock you down and keep kids out of school and keep you out of your church. These are the same people that have been on a quiet war on Christianity and on Christmas and will continue to be on that war. These are the same people that have continuously, one after another, when they run out of one thing and something gets disproven, they move on to the next thing. Well, they're on the next thing now. January 6th. And you're going to believe all this stuff coming forth from their ever-lying mouths? Just like you believed all the other stuff that was disproven? Only the ignorant do. Most of us in our circles know the truth, and we go on with our lives, and we, you know, maybe we don't speak up enough. Maybe we're guilty of just rolling our eyes. Maybe we should lose our temper a little more, or put wayward friends and family members in their place, because those people that support these lies and help perpetuate these lies or what's going to cause their grandchildren or great-grandchildren to not be able to do what I'm doing today. Go to a job that they choose. Pursue a career that they choose. Because these people that continuously come up with ways to divide us with all kinds of things are the people that will eventually have so much power, if we let them, that they will decide where you go to work, where you go to school, what your career will be. History has proven many times that groups who want to take complete control of a country first do everything they can to tear down the society, to make people dependent, to make people unhappy, to divide populations. And January 6th is their newest, latest, greatest tool. Why are there still people in jail for trespassing in the Capitol? Why have they not been given a public trial? I thought timely prosecution was a law. And I heard this moment of silence that the House of Representatives and the Senate had today. What do they have a moment of silence for? Who died? An innocent civilian. A veteran that was shot. And she was unarmed. She was shot by a Capitol policeman. We don't have all the details. Why haven't we seen all the films yet? Why are there people in some of the films that we have seen who have not been arrested? Were they plants? Antifa? BLM? FBI? There's a lot of stuff that stinks about January the 6th. It smelled bad to me when it was happening. Why was there no National Guard? Why was that refused ahead of time? So many questions not being answered. But yet we have this committee pretending to look into what happened. And they're going to perpetuate their lies, just like they have on all these other stories I mentioned, and many, many more that I can't think of at the moment. They're going to perpetuate their lies over and over and over again until they're disproven. And then they'll move on to their next set of lies to divide us and feed the ignorant masses what they need to walk around and think their holier-than-thou thoughts as they genuflect to the altar of liberalism. I saw that the Attorney General in Georgia is looking into some huge amounts of ballot harvesting that went on during that election, that there was allegedly no proof that there was any cheating. Well, there's lots of proof in lots of states, and that will come out eventually, slowly but surely. Maybe Georgia will be the first to blow it out. And when it's all said and done, the ignorant masses will do like they've done with everything else, whether it's Russia, 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 Benghazi, IRS gate. They'll have moved on. They will have forgotten about it. Short attention spans is loved by these people today that are standing behind podiums and telling you their version of what happened 1 year ago today. Their newest set of lies. Don't forget, this is just another in a long line of lies. Be safe, my friends. Be well. Try to stay healthy. But mostly, try to stay aware. Don't get sucked into this swamp draining that will eventually have to take place. Don't be part of the swamp in Washington. Have a good day.